Iteration in Go. This is by me, Abram Hindle. I'm an assistant professor of computing science in the Department of Computing Science at the University of Alberta. I teach software engineering and stuff like that. This talk is licensed under CC by SA 4.0, and the code is mostly Apache 2. All right. So when I was doing this, I was bothered by making intent maps and things like that. So what I thought I'd do is, well, I could make a map interface. So Go allows us to use interfaces. So I thought, I'm going to make a map interface, and it's going to allow me to take a slice of ints, and it's going to let me produce any kind of output. So what I did is I made this method. This method's on ints. I define ints as a slice of ints, and it's called map, and takes a callback of e to e. Now, e is type E interface with nothing. It's a blank interface. And my map is a blank interface. So our mapper interface is map with a function that takes a blank interface to blank interface and produces a slice of blank interfaces. The reducer was going to look pretty similar. It's going to be a function that takes in two blank interfaces, produces a blank interface, and returns one final blank interface value. We could have saved typing in these blank interfaces all the time just by using our type E here. And that's the E that I'm referring to here. So this is blank interface, blank interface, blank interface, blank interface. So our map looks pretty well the same. We make a slice of blank interfaces. Then we apply this callback V. It returns a blank interface, takes in a blank interface type object, and we assign it to out, and then we return out. To call it, what we'll do is we'll first take our list of ints, vex, we'll call it ints, so this is just coercing the type, and then we go dot map, and we pass in a function. Unfortunately, this is the ugly part. Our function takes in a blank interface and returns a blank interface. So because this isn't an int, I have to coerce it down to an int. So I go x, you're an int, plus 1. Okay? So this will completely fail if x isn't an int. But what's nice is I don't have to care too much about the type of the return value. The return value will be accessible. It will be a blank interface, but I'll be able to access it. So what I'll do is I'll say generic map of evex, the return value here. Let's just print it. So what happens is, since this is an increment, it goes 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What I want to show you about this neat function is that since it can return a list, right? A list of blank interfaces, it can return any type. So watch this. We come in here, we take an x, we know that this vex is full of integers, but we convert it to float 32. So this is convert the type to float 32 after we get the integer representation and add 1.1 to it. So it's like the increment except we added 0.1 to it. And you can see here the result is float 32s. We get floats out. So this function is actually very powerful. It allows us to output slices of the type of the return value. So that's pretty nice. So we gain a little bit with the type inference. Unfortunately, we'd have to do the same thing for string, right? So what I wanted to do was I wanted to basically make a generic map that would convert collections, so lists of blank interfaces, empty interfaces, convert lists of these to other lists of them. So basically collection to collection, right? So I wanted a map, I want to give a callback, goes E to E, so empty interface to empty interface, produce a list of empty interfaces. So this is all fine and good, but you got to ask yourself, can we actually call this? The answer is, there is a problem. The problem is that if you have a slice of strings, it's not the same as a slice of blank interfaces. This isn't a blank, this is a slice. This isn't a blank interface. This whole thing is not two parts. It's one part. It's one type, a slice of blank interfaces. You know what it's not? It's not a slice of strings, and it's not a slice of ints. So that's problematic, isn't it? It means that we need to pass in, if we want to call the map method, it has to be a collection of blank interfaces. That's the only way we can use this, because this is a special type. Well, it's not a special type. This is just a slice. That's all it is. You know, Go doesn't care that this is a blank interface. What Go cares is that this thing is called a slice of blank interfaces. Okay? So this means we have to make a slice of blank interfaces, which is awkward. So what we have to do here is we basically have to make a collection. So here I got SVEX is a string of a slice of strings, A string, B string, C string. And to be able to call that method, I've got to make an empty interface slice. So I've got a function that I've called collection. And what it does is it converts a list, like a slice here, to a slice of empty interfaces. Then we can call map on it. And our map still has this ugly notation where we have a value x of empty type, produces empty type, and then we have to coerce everything and cast everything down to what we expect it to be. But nonetheless, it allows us to work. So for, let's see, generic map of string, we're basically concatenating two strings together, doubling them. We get AA, BB, CC. So that's string to string. The cool thing is we also gain that genericity. We can do strings to ints now. So we can go len x string. So that's 1, 1, 1, because A, B, C, right? You see A, B, C, all their lengths are 1, okay? We can do the same thing with our ints as long as we cast them. But we need to convert them, unfortunately. We need to convert them to a collection, or a slice of blank interfaces. How do we do this? Well, I found this Stack Overflow post that was very helpful. And this is a simplified version of it. We use the reflect module. What I say is collection takes a slice of stuff. And look, it's not a slice. I just say a blank interface. So I'm saying it accepts something and it expects it to be a slice, right? So this is danger zone, right? I'm not saying a slice of stuff, I'm saying anything. And it's going to produce a collection. So what it does is we go reflect value of slice of stuff, our slice. And then we act like it's a slice. So we go our slice length, and we produce that output array, that output slice. We go I equals 0, I less than our slice length, I plus plus. And then we go get the element from there and get the blank interface version of that and plunk it into out I and return out. So it's like our map. We're basically mapping our values to blank interfaces, right? It's a little bit awkward. This is needed because basically our blank interface is like a struct that has two elements in it, and one element will be the thing you wrapped up, that interface type, as well, or that value, and then also the type, the blank interface. So it's pretty annoying. So what happens is we use this collection method and we can write our map very simply. So we go, we can make a map method that takes a collection E, takes a callback, returns a collection of empties, empty interfaces, and all we do is we take this. Notice how it's not this. This is just an empty interface. We pretend this is a slice and we'll map it. So this thing is going to break at runtime if you put the wrong thing in it. Also, it's got to wrap everything up. We can write our reduce pretty well the same way. So here's our generic reduce. We take in a collection. It goes E to E to E, and it outputs an E. So we go O equals initialize it with that value, and then go through it all. Finally return O after calling our callbacks and getting all the output. And then our generic reduce is just collection of this empty interface. This is a hack I really don't like. This is not type safe. It sort of ticks me off that I have to do this. And it's not very fast. And then we just call reduce on it. We just call reduce as a method. So that's pretty neat, right? So this means we can do generic map reduce in Go. We could also do it with parallelism if we wanted to. We could go and port that ugly int, or that ugly parallel int map and int map reduce. We could go port it to this kind of thing. But quite frankly, the whole uh, the whole affair of dropping type information and abusing runtime reflection to be able to pull us off turned me off of it a bit. And the whole point of using the parallelism would be that you probably wanted to increase performance, so this would not be a performance increasing kind of deal. Nonetheless, it's pretty neat that you're able to pull it off in Go, and it's relatively safe, but at the end of the day, you still have to pull those values back, right? Because they're all empty interfaces. You got to pull them back to something useful. So how do we evaluate it? What does it look like? Because I've just been showing you the code, right? So how do we actually apply it? So here we go map. We put in any value we want. So I'm going vex. Remember what vex was? Do you? Vex was, it was back here a little bit. Nope, not there. Vex is over here. It's just an int slice, 1 to 9. So we go to vex. And we say, I've got this function, takes empty interface, produce empty interface. We get the int version of it, and we square it. So slow map res will be the square of vex. So it will produce 1, 4, 9, all the way to 81, because that's 9 times 9. We can also do slow map reduce. So here I take the output of this mapping and I reduce it and I use a reduction that's just sums. So it will give me the sum of that, which is 285. Okay. So we can use this generic reduce. Now, the reason why I have this as a function is because then I can take that E empty empty interface and I can call reduce on it. And what you should know is every time I pass this in, it's calling collection on it, right? So it makes a collection. This is a cost, and you have to garbage collect and throw away, and it's a big waste of memory. And then it calls map on that new collection you made. Remember, this collection we called make, so there was allocation involved. Nonetheless, we get a generic map reduce. There's probably better ways of doing this. I don't know Go very well. But I knew enough Go to pull this one off and be able to Google it pretty hard and be able to work it out. Nonetheless, it's pretty neat you can pull this off. Easier functions to pull off would be things like an each, like in Ruby, an iter or an each, where you just say, hey, collection, apply this closure to every element in there, and it returns nothing, so don't worry about it. But there's not a lot of point doing that in Go since you already have the for loop and the range method. Or the range function. So what's the point?